Let's go beyond Christmas. Let's go beyond holiday celebration. Let's go beyond gift giving. Let's go into the revelation of Emmanuel, God with us, revealed in us, because Jesus Christ has come as God incarnate into man. So God is not only with us, the omniscient God, who has promised he would never leave us nor forsake us. And as he was with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob, he was going to be with us. And when we pass through the fire and the storm and floods, that God would be with us. But because of Jesus Christ, his crucifixion, his death, his burial, his resurrection, and his ascension, sitting now on the right-hand side of the Father, he has taken the blood to the holies of holies that speaks of better things than the old covenant. He's taken the blood of man to the holies of holies and says man has now a right to come boldly to the throne room of God. Let your Christmas and holiday celebration go beyond gift giving and food and ornaments. And that's a nice thing to do. I'm not judging you on whatever level you do. And if you have a problem with that, then forgive those who still do. But the biggest thing we should focus on is now God has fulfilled his promise. He says, I'm going to live in you. I'm going to walk in you, and you are going to be my people. I'm going to be your God. Emmanuel, God with us, revealed in us. God with us, revealed in us. And how is he revealed? He is revealed as Yahweh Sitkanu. Yes, Jehovah God, my righteousness. And we are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. In Christ Jesus. And he's revealed as Yahweh Mikdash. He's my sanctifier. And he's made to me wisdom, righteousness, and sanctification. And he is my Yahweh Shalom. Not something I have to reach for, because this is not something the world gave and the world could take away. This is inside of me. This is God himself. Yes. The God of peace has become my peace, because Jesus Christ has broken down every wall of partition. Because mercy and truth have met together. Mercy said, oh, the truth said, wages of sin is death. But mercy said, but the grace of God, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Mercy and truth have met together. Righteousness. And because I was not righteous, we were not righteous. We didn't have peace with God, but Jesus Christ has come to be, bring us righteousness in him and peace in him. And where is that? Not in a building made by hands. That is in us. So the babe on the cross, the babe in the manger, you have to move from the babe in the manger and see that even when he was a babe in the manger, the resurrection was already a done deal. Because he was already the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. He was already the great I Am. He was already a part of the triune God. But he thought it not robbery. I mean, he laid down his robe of glory so he can come through man and do what Adam wouldn't do, do what Adam couldn't do. And when Adam said this, the first Adam said, there's something wrong with the woman you gave me. And he committed treason with that, with Eve. And then he turned his back on God and Eve. He didn't cover her with love, because love covers a multitude of sin. And God looked for one who's going to show mercy, who's going to show grace. And Jesus said, here am I, who counted it all joy. To bring us into the adoption of the family of God with all of its inheritance and all of its benefits and all of its promises and provisions and everything that is in Christ, the fulfillment God in Christ is now in us. But we have to get beyond the manger, and we have to die to self. We have to be crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, we live. We have to be dead and buried in our lives, hidden in Him. We have to die to self. We also have to be risen in Christ Jesus. And don't you know, the same power that raised Christ from the dead dwells in your mortal body and quickens you. We have to be quickened and ascend and sit in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. But we have to die to self first, because God will share His glory with no other. We have to die, and we have to go through the process. And as Jesus, as Christ, has come to grant us access to the Father by becoming man, so that we can have the kingdom of God within. May you receive the revelation that it's more than a babe in a manger. May you receive the revelation that it's more than tinsel and ornaments. May you receive the revelation that it's more than going to church and watching special programs, and that's nice, be entertained, but it's more than that. This rescue mission is not only just was for you, but it's for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth. And when you look around, you say that's the whosoever God wants to show His glory and His love and redeem and bring Him into the adoption of sons. The whole earth groaneth in travails for the sons of God to get a clue to see why God was so mindful of us, of me and you, that He would reveal His glory through us so people can come to know and get a visual picture of God's love as we tell them the story beyond the cross, as we tell them the story about the crucifixion and the resurrection. Be blessed. Know that your life is an opportunity to bring someone to Christ. And this is what it's all about. It's the gift of salvation. The gift of salvation. That's what it was all about. And it was all about love. It's a love thing. Walk in love. And wise men win souls. Walk in love. Because if you love me, you're going to feed a sheep. Walk in love so we can fulfill the Great Commission. Tell somebody about Jesus Christ. That's the best gift you can give. Tell somebody why you love them so much. That's the best gift you can give, among the best gifts you can give. Tell them how He saved you and He redeemed you and He brought you out of darkness into light. That's the best gift you can give. Give the gift of life. Plant a seed. Sow a seed. Fertilize the ground around the seed. Plant, put water on it. If someone has already planted a seed, put water on it and pray that God will bring it to harvest. And souls would light up the world with the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and how good He is. God bless you. Happy holiday to you.